Well, welcome, welcome everyone. My name is Jeannie Bergot and I am the president of InterNews. And we are really thrilled to welcome you here to the launch of InterNews Next, a celebration of the next generation of media and information leaders around the world. It happens in conjunction with our 30th anniversary, but rather than focus on our increasing gray hairs, we would rather think about the next 30 years and think about the next leaders and the future generations who will be making such amazing impact in media and information ecologies around the world. And that's what our panel is about today, which I'll introduce in a minute. But before we begin, I want to do a little look back into time to 1982. So, a few facts about 1982. Thank you, Laura. Time's Man of the Year was the computer. USA Today was launched as a national newspaper. The first smiley face was used as an emoticon, an email message. And the first lovable computer was introduced in the Commodore 64 with its 64 kilobytes of memory. Began to be sold. And of course, a small, now tiny nonprofit in Arcata, California named InterNews was launched with the grand goals of bringing world peace to media and information. And we really haven't done too poorly in the last 30 years. In the 1980s, our groundbreaking satellite space bridges united citizens of the United States and the Soviet Union for the first time. In the 1990s, we aided and abetted the new media outlets that emerged with the collapse of the Soviet Union and other places, such as the fall, such as post-Suharto Indonesia. In the aughts, am I saying it right? The aughts, yes, right? That's great. In the aughts, we recognized the power of information and media didn't just affect the way democracies are set up or the way political systems are set up, but could also be used to solve some of the most pressing problems facing the world, including environmental degradation, global health, and humanitarian response. And of course, in the last decade, in the last 5 years specifically, we have unleashed our curiosity, unleashed our own sort of thinking as we look and embrace new digital technologies around the world and explore how people are producing, consuming, sharing news and information in all new ways and all new systems around the world. And we as an organization are really committed to trying to learn more about that, think more about that, and figure out ways that the information ecologies are changing, ways that we can improve our programs. Along those lines, we have launched our new Center on Innovation and Learning, and we have a number of center staff in this room, including Mark Frohart, a longtime InterNewser, but now our executive director of the center. And other center staff, please raise your hands. We have information about it, but this is a place where we hope to share with you what we're learning and exploring. We're excited as one of our commitments to the future and the future of media through InterNews Next. But now I will stop speaking and turn it over to our very inspirational panel.
Going to have to read their bios.
I'm going to introduce all three of our panelists, and then each of them will come and speak, and we'll have a little bit of time for questions of each one, and we'll open it up for questions after the whole panel for everybody. So our first speaker is Vladimir Chekhov, who is a producer of Matrix, a youth-oriented TV program focused on the latest developments in internet and technology for 13 to 25-year-olds across Central Asia. A new Matrix episode is produced each week in Russian and Kazakh and translated into all 5 Central Asian languages. Recent programs have covered how to protect computers and mobile phones from theft and ensure online privacy, and a school for tech whizzes in Tajikistan. Next up will be Don Stollard, our Senior Program Officer for InterNews and Afghanistan, who collaborated with local partners to create the Afghan Youth Festival, Youth Voices Festival, aimed at providing multimedia skills to young people to express themselves. In 2001, 2,200 young people took part in Afghan Youth Festival activities, including the first ever Afghan women's group blog, cartoon and graffiti workshops, a music festival, and photography workshops and exhibitions. And I think Don is going to show us some pictures from this, which are truly extraordinary. Finally, we have Erica Williams, a civic innovator, social commentator, and activist, passionate about engaging the next generation in civic life. She is currently a senior strategist at the Citizen Engagement Lab, CEL. It's an incubator for people power projects that use digital media and technology to engage communities in social change.